Good morning. The next topic is linkage. We know the chromosome contain genes, and number of genes an individual is not equal to number of chromosomes. So it is clearly an indication that more than one gene present on a chromosome. So if this chromosome segregate as per the theory of chromosomal inheritance by Sutton and Boveri, one chromosome goes to one gamete. That means chromosome segregate. So what happens? All the alleles present on this chromosome moves as a block. Let us take A, small b, capital C, capital D, capital E, capital F and capital G. These are the genes present on this chromosome. They all move together. That means capital A, small b, capital C, D, E, F, G all move together to one of the gametes. It's other, that is small a, capital B and rest all the genes move together. So we say that on a chromosome, there are genes which are actually linked together. Why we call them linked together? Because they move as a block to the next generation. This is the concept of linkage. In human being, there are 23 pairs of linkage groups. So each chromosome is a linkage group, and they move as a block from one generation to another. The alleles present on that chromosome move as a block from one generation to another. Look at this picture. We can see the linkage group A and B, which are moving together to one of the chromosomes. That means whenever A moves, capital B also move together. In the other individual, small a and small b together, again they comes together. So wherever you see capital A, along with that you can see the capital B. This condition is known as linkage. So we can say that there is no independent movement of alleles here. That means A and B are linked together, so they move together. So here the law of independent assortment is not completely followed in the case of linkage, but still they independently move. It means capital A, capital B, we have seen they are linked together, but still we can see the capital A and B moves to different individual, not always, at certain times. The reason behind it is a natural phenomenon known as crossing over, a phenomenon which is seen in meiosis. Meiosis is a type of cell division which is seen in organism at the time of gamete formation. Capital A, capital B, small a, small b. See, by the process of crossing over, in the next generation we can see capital A, small b, small a, capital B. Now, how this has come? I'll explain you. We'll take one chromosome only. I think this is the chromosome capital A, capital B, and the other chromosome small a, small b. Here this part of chromosome is exchanged. When they exchange the parts, capital A and small b come together, and in the other condition small a and capital B. So this happens due to crossing over. I'll make it clear with another diagram. We can see homologous chromosomes, same size, same genetic combination, where capital A, B, C on one chromosome, small a, B, C on another chromosome. Here you can see the process of crossing over, where homologous chromosomes, they exchange their parts, exchange of segments between non-sister chromatids. These two are known as sister chromatids. This one and this one is together known as non-sister chromatids. Exchange of segments between non-sister chromatids leads to change in the combination. So here the linkage group breaks. Thus we can say some sort of independent assortment has been taken. This is very logical that alleles which are situated very close together, less chance of separation between them, whereas the alleles which are located far away will have more chance, because कहीं पे भी इसके बीच में क्रॉसिंग ओवर हो गया तो ये और इसके बीच में इंडिपेंडेंट असॉर्टमेंट होगा, और ये दोनों बहुत क्लोजली एसोसिएटेड है तो यहीं पे ही उनका क्रॉसिंग ओवर आना है, तब जाके वो सेपरेट होंगे. दिस इज रिगार्डिंग लिंकेज एंड क्रॉसिंग ओवर. थैंक यू.